Let's start by clearly defining what Zone 2 is. First of all, it's nothing new, as it has been around for decades among endurance athletes. Pioneered by the work of Iñigo San-Millán, Ph.D., Zone 2 is the effort you can maintain while keeping your lactate below 2 mmol. It's that sweet spot where your body starts producing some lactate, but you have the capacity to clear it out, maintaining it below that threshold, ideally between 1.7 and 1.9 mmol. So if you really want to know your Zone 2, you would have to do a lactate test. That can get a bit expensive, but I actually found the lactate meter on Amazon, linked in the description, for $180, which can be a good investment to ensure the most accurate training. Otherwise, you can gauge your Zone 2 by checking several factors. First, aim for an effort that you can carry out while breathing in and out through your nose without forcing your breath. Second, is an effort at which you can still maintain a conversation, but less comfortably than if you were simply walking. Third, your heart rate should be pretty stable and around 60 to 70% of your maximum HR. This is just a very generic indication, but if you use these three parameters combined, you will have more chances to find that sweet spot. Moving on, to truly understand the benefits of Zone 2 training, we need to take a closer look at what happens in our muscle fibers. Zone 2 is the exercise intensity where you have the maximum expression of the slow twitch muscle fibers, also known as red fibers or type 1 fibers. The reason why that is important is because fat can be burned during exercise only in the mitochondria present in those slow twitch muscle fibers. Hence, Zone 2 provides the highest fat oxidation, the process by which the body breaks down fats, triglycerides, into smaller molecules, such as free fatty acids and glycerol, which can then be used as a source of energy. All this translates into having the highest stimulation at a mitochondrial level. The two primary benefits of Zone 2 cardio are increasing mitochondrial efficiency and improving metabolic flexibility, meaning your body can more easily switch between utilizing glucose or fat as an energy source. But the benefits don't stop there. This kind of training, in fact, also reduces your resting heart rate and blood pressure, improves endurance, and reduces insulin resistance, which is at the base of many chronic diseases. The thing is, to really harness all of these benefits, there are some important things to consider. So let's now take a closer look at what the common mistakes are. If you found this video helpful and want more, then check out the full video link in the description. While if you're looking for clear guidance for your health and longevity journey, you might be interested in our new longevity coaching program. It's a 3-month one-on-one coaching program where you get a comprehensive plan for your health and longevity. You can learn more about it and request more info by visiting the link in the description. Thanks a lot for watching, subscribe to our channel, and see you in the next one.